We waited more than 700 days for snow. Then, just last week, those long-awaited flakes finally arrived.
It's so much fun.
Oh, very excited. I'm going to throw lots of snowballs, my other friends, when they get here.
Really excited. I was really happy. Got my friends' dogs and even my cat try to get outside just to see the snow. You know, I haven't seen it in a while, so it was really great to just see the snow, playing it, and, you know, feel it on my fingertips.
And Maryland was far from the only state dealing with this winter weather. This morning, we chat with meteorologist Ava Marie, the trends we're seeing as our climate changes. Plus, the snow was welcome news for Liberty Mountain Resort. Their plans for the rest of the winter season with thousands seeking the slopes. And later,
we want to be the gold standard. We want to be the best children's museum in the country.
This is not just an idea from Port Discovery. It's a promise and commitment to serve Maryland's children. As the museum marks 25 years in Baltimore, what its team has its sights set on for the next 25. That's all this morning on 11 TV Hill. And hi, everyone. I'm Jason Newton. Welcome to 11 TV Hill. Maryland's snow drought came to a screeching and long-awaited halt last week. But what does our nearly two-year snow pause show about Maryland's climate trends? We'll get to that in a moment. First, let's go back to the scenes of our first major snowfall.
2 years is a very long time to wait to go sledding like this, kids told us today, between runs down a very big hill in Towson.
Oh, very excited.
Yeah, I'm also excited.
You don't seem very excited.
Well, I'm not excited to climb up that hill like 15 times. It'll be fun coming back down, so I'm excited for that.
By lunchtime on Tuesday, the snowfall was done. The freezing rain that followed had tapered off, the frigid temperatures had taken hold, and people were out and about in Baltimore.
So I wondered if you guys worry about power outages. It looked like the lines were really heavy.
Yes, yes. You can see all the wooded lots we have back here, lots of trees, so we do lose power quite often.
Is that something you're worried about going into this evening?
Yes, yes. But I'm fortunate I do have a generator. So luckily I'm prepared.
Many were clearing off cars and sidewalks and driveways for the first time in years.
I love it. I love the snow, you know. I haven't seen snow, would you say 2 years? Yes, I really love it.
So you love the snow, you just don't love shoveling it.
I don't love shoving it at my age anyway.
Drivers we talked to said slick in spots, some dicey side streets, but so far, so good.
Pretty good. I mean, in the neighborhoods, it's definitely slushy and a little, you know, dicey, but the main roads seem fine.
They're wet and slushy, but that's not too bad.
For 11 TV Hill, I'm Kate Amara.
So if you're wondering why we are doing a snow episode, just take a live look outside. We're doing this on Friday. So at this point right now, we are dealing with a snowstorm, and you can see some pictures outside for us. This is the second snowstorm that we have had come through this week, and Ava Marie is nice enough to steal some time away from her busy work right now. Thank you for doing this.
Hey, it's been a busy week.
Yeah,
and we're out of practice.
Yeah.
It's been 2 years since we've had a decent snowfall, so this was really something we had to get used to dealing with once again. Mixed emotions.
Sure.
I mean, fun for the kids, treacherous for the parents on the roads, and for dealing with school disruptions.
Sure. And of course, again, this is Friday, so schools were all closed today. So just compare these two storms, because I feel like there are some similarities between today's and what we saw earlier in the week.
Yeah, it was heavy enough to impact the roads and cold enough to allow it to really stick as well. And then it got really icy because it was so cold afterwards. But the most notable thing about this was the fact that we broke the snow drought.
Yeah, that's impressive.
Yeah, so look at these stats here. So on January 15th, we got 4.1 inches of snow at BWI, which was the most we've seen in 2 years. It broke the streak of snowless days.
Wow.
There at the airport. We had gone 716 days starting from January 22nd all the way until January 2024. So it was a long stretch without snow. And really, you think overall last year we only measured 0.2 inches. 0.2 inches,
right?
Not even an inch,
yeah,
the whole last winter at BWI. So to get at least enough to play in was really exciting for the kids. And it definitely caused a lot of problems on the roads when people weren't used to it. What made the snow kind of different from maybe some of the past events,
yeah,
it was such a powdery snow, and that's because it was so cold. We had a strong Arctic front,
yeah,
come through earlier in the week, and then another one which brought more of the snow on this Friday.
Yeah, and I think we have some video of that blowing snow, because it makes such a difference out there, especially on the roads. because once you think you're done with it, as you see there, it just blows its way back out, and it can make roads pretty treacherous.
Yeah, you know, seeing video like this reminds me more of what the snow was like where I grew up in Denver, where it was so powdery that it kind of just drifted across the roads. In fact, in some of those colder locations where they get more of this powdery snow, a lot of times they actually don't treat with salt because they don't want the snow to stick. They want it to keep blowing. The problem here, it never stays a powdery snow long.
Okay.
What starts as powdery then starts to meld and turn slushy, and that's when things get really slick. But I like to show this video too because it reminds you that snow is just not about the accumulation, it's about the visibility.
Yeah. You mentioned temperatures also. We've stayed pretty cold for a bit throughout this week. I mean, this is cold we hadn't seen in a bit.
Yeah, and that's an important reminder when it's going to get really cold following a snow. You want to do your best to clear off sidewalks and driveways quickly after the snow has stopped, because what we saw from Tuesday into Wednesday, everything just iced over if it wasn't taken care of.
Yeah, walk me through some fun, because you guys, I know it's not fun, it's work, but you added a little excitement to snowstorms. You guys were taking sort of a wager on who could guess this first storm, and the winner was this time?
Yeah, I'll give it to Tony Pan. He started the snow, well, for starting the snow contest, not winning. So Tony thought we would get snow in November, and we did get some cold air back there, but it was never enough to bring snow. Delencio was hoping for a white Christmas. That didn't happen. Now, honorable mention to Tom, because we did get a trace of snow at BWI on December 11th, which was really close to his guess, and I almost wanted to honor him as the winner because I think more than a trace fell, but that's all they actually measured.
Okay.
The thing is, though, Chelsea hit it right on the head. On January 15th, we got that 4 inches of snow at the airport. So she is officially the winner of this snow contest. And I even gave her a small little award that she has on her desk.
A little snowflake. And listen, we didn't talk about this off camera before, but you guys look at models. I mean, this isn't just pure guessing. I mean, you have a number of models and a number of computer systems to sort of help guide you on when things could happen.
I'll say, you know, trying to guess the first snowfall date, we guessed that back in October. That's a bit like playing the lottery. You're trying to look at when the cold snaps might be, but really the chance of snow comes within a week of our view.
Okay.
However, when we are forecasting snow, we're looking at a lot of things in the short term, the temperatures, the timing, the energy in the atmosphere. And that's why some of these storms overperformed.
Okay.
More snow than people might have expected, because there was a lot of energy and a lot of oomph to these storms that came in.
A lot of work was done, a lot of fun as well outside. I think we have video of people having a good time out there. This was, listen, yes, it is a hardship when you do have to go to the store or you have to go to school, but there are kids out there and I guess animals as well.
Four-legged friends.
They really
enjoy it. I know. I think that's where maybe this snow had mixed emotions, because it can be really stressful to deal with, but because we haven't seen much in a while, it was exciting. And you can see these pets, you know, some of them, depending on their age, they may not remember snow.
Oh, sure. Well, I've seen two types of dogs on,
but he's eating it.
On the internet. They either run outside and love it, or they put one paw out and like, forget it. I don't want anything to do with this.
Oh, my God.
There's another. Oh. This is Rachel's corgi, Gus Gus. Gus Gus is very aerodynamic. He keeps it low to the ground, but he stays out there for a long time.
I love it. He's like a snow shovel himself because he's so low to the ground.
He's just dragging
a path for them.
And we aren't alone. Out in Michigan, they did a little bit of a sculpture, I believe, out there, a whale sculpture. And it just shows, one, just how cold it gets out there. But also, there's some creativity. Goodness, he put a lot of work in this.
I wonder what kind of spray paint he's using, like if there's like more biodegradable, I don't know.
Well, something tells me that this isn't his first time, whatever he's using, and he's putting a lot of work into this.
You know what I like about this video? It reminds us that we don't always get snow.
Sure.
And so it is an opportunity to kind of live in the moment, think outside the box, use the snow as your art form, and have some fun with it.
I love it. And let's remind people of the WBAL-TV app. Everything is there. Interactive radar. You have, you can look right down to your street of where the snow is. Also, the hourly forecast is great as well.
Yeah, the hope is that we want to give you as much warning ahead of a snow event so that you can be prepared, stay safe, and then plan out some time to have fun as well.
This was fun. Thanks for doing this.
Hey, winter's not over yet.
Now I must shovel.